Gartner is a global research and advisory firm, and it defines big data as high volume, high velocity, and or high variety information assets that demand cost-effective, innovative forms of information processing, and that enables enhanced insights and decision-making process automation. So this is a formal definition from Gartner, but now we will move on to the whiteboard and we will be discussing the other definition of big data, which will be much more detailed, and I will be adding a lot of things from my side in that definition. So let's start with that.
So big data definition. I will be focusing on 5 V's. We will start with volume, first V. Second V is velocity. Third V is variety. Fourth V is veracity. Fifth V is value. So volume is like the data which is coming from different sources, that is huge. Right, so the data that we are getting every day is huge, and it's growing very fast as per IDC. So there is an organization IDC which predicts that global data sphere will grow to 175 zettabyte by 2025. Now, what is zettabyte? 1 zettabyte is equal to 1 million petabyte. 1 million petabyte. So it will grow to 175 zettabyte. So it's growing very fast, and we have data coming from different sources, including credit card transactions. We have data coming from sensors. We have data coming from different videos, images. So much data is coming. So it is growing very fast. So it cannot be handled by our traditional system. So when we say data is big, then actually, we are referring to this thing like it cannot be handled by our traditional technologies, and that's why we need some other technologies which will allow us to work with this data efficiently and effectively. Instead of archiving this data on magnetic tapes, we want to use it in our day-to-day analysis. So that's the purpose of having a kind of environment which is also called data lake. I will be explaining about data lake soon, but for the time being, just understand we have to handle so much volume and it cannot be handled by traditional technologies. That's why we need some innovative solutions to overcome this problem. Second problem that we face is about velocity, and the data that is growing on the internet is very fast. If you know, Google, more than 3.6 million searches are happening every minute. Similarly, Weather Channel is receiving more than 18 million forecast requests in a single minute. So this is something which is happening at a very fast pace, and it's very difficult to cater to such kind of requirements. So YouTube, also you will see people are watching 4.1 million videos in just 1 minute. So it is very fast. It's very difficult to handle extremely fast data, and we want to analyze this data when it is flowing. So data is streaming at a very fast rate, at a very fast pace. So another one is variety. When I say variety, there can be different types of data. One is structured, unstructured, or semi-structured. So there are three different types of data: structured. So structured data can easily be handled by relational databases, but it also depends on the size of the data. Relational databases will start to fail, or they become too much expensive when the size will be beyond few terabytes, couple of terabytes. Structured data. So when we have stringent schema, then we say it is a structured data. And then another one is semi-structured data, and then we have unstructured. So let's discuss unstructured first. Unstructured means no schema. Semi-structured means schema may be there, or may not be there. You know, more than 85% of the data is unstructured these days, because this data, like videos, images, nowadays internet cost is very low, and the devices like camera and other devices, sensors, they are not expensive. So these sources are actually responsible for generating 85% of the total data, which is unstructured. So structured data is RDBMS. So example of this is RDBMS, relational databases. Example of unstructured data is like videos, images, and other types of data. Semi-structured example is you have this particular thing like XML. XML may have schema, may not have schema. Log files, they are also not structured. So there are many examples of semi-structured data. So next V is about veracity. Veracity is messiness in data. So we want to basically clean our data. We cannot rely on the data which is there. So you need to do cleansing. Clean the data, and you have to maintain the quality. And apart from that, if you don't maintain a quality, then the data will be meaningless, and it will be very, very dangerous in terms of like concluding certain results. So it's very important that we should have cleanliness or quality of data should be up to the standards that we are looking for. Okay, apart from that, we want to gain actionable insights. So we can gain actionable insights from data, and this will add value to the business, right? So we want to basically collect the data, we want to store it, we want to analyze it, we want to retrieve the results from the data, the value from the data, so that it can be monetized in some way. So this is another V. So this is very high level definition of big data, like what is big data. In simple terms, the things that could not be done with traditional system in cost effective manner is basically big data, very high level definition. Now, I also want to show you the overall picture, like what exactly big data has. Okay, so I like this blog a lot personally, because I see a lot of important stuff has been added in this blog. If you see on this blog, you will find a lot of big data projects. So in order to overcome those 5 V's problem, there are so many processing frameworks, like one is Hadoop, and then you will find distributed programming frameworks. There are so many distributed programming frameworks like Pig, MapReduce, Spark, Storm, Taze. So there are so many technologies which were developed just for distributed programming. If you scroll down further, it takes time to actually scroll down, because there are so many things. The idea is not to look into the technology. Idea is to see the high level categories and see the breadth of big data systems, like the frameworks or the libraries which have been developed. So this is distributed file system, and there are so many distributed file systems available, including HDFS, and then you will find Kudu and other file systems. This is key map data model, and here you will find Bigtable and many other systems. This one is document data model. Here you will find MongoDB and other systems related to MongoDB, like RavenDB and TerraStore. So key value data model. So this one is having CouchDB, and you will find there are other interesting MemcacheDB. Yeah, so you can see we have another section which is called graph data model, and here you will find Neo4j and many other technologies. Apart from that, we have NewSQL. This is another trend which is going on after NoSQL. So there also we have lot of technologies under that. VaultDB is one of the common examples. Columnar databases, you will find like multiple types of columnar databases, like Vertica, and you will find MonetDB. So there are Apache Arrow is also very common. Time series databases, we have InfluxDB, which is common. OpenTSDB, also very common. So you can see so many frameworks, like this is SQL related frameworks, and here you will find data ingestion related stuff. Yeah, so there are so many things going on here. I'm just scrolling faster. You can see the level of breadth. So I would suggest like go to this blog and have a look and see like which all technologies exist within big data. So hope this is fine, like you got an idea about big data. What is big data?
Now let's start exploring key big data technologies which are common in production environment.